A trooper did not follow Highway Patrol protocol back in May.
It's been 4 months since 20-year-old Brandon Ellingson drowned in Trooper Anthony Piercy's custody. Ellingson was arrested on suspicion of drinking while boating. And after a coroner's inquest into Ellingson's death this month, the jury ruled his death accidental.
ABC 17's Heather Horrigan has been looking through Highway Patrol's marine operations curriculum today. And Heather, the way Trooper Piercy handcuffed and put his life vest on Ellingson was wrong.
It was, according to the Water Patrol training curriculum and general orders I have. Although Ellingson was handcuffed and placed in the proper seat, in here it says a vest with a collar design must be used. This type of vest with the collar allows for an unconscious person to float face up. But this wasn't the vest Piercy used on Ellingson, instead this one, which he slipped out of. 23 days of Marine operations training, and Trooper Anthony Piercy claims he was never taught how to handcuff and life vest a person. His training included survival swimming, BWI detection, and a boating safety course. Captain Tim Hull with the Missouri Highway Patrol could not go into detail about each course in Piercy's training, but tells me I will need to request lesson plans. I did request general orders regarding handcuffing and life vest. Hull tells me every trooper is taught the general orders. Here is what I found pertaining to Brandon Ellingson's death. Under general order regarding transportation aboard patrol vessels, it reads, any prisoner transported in a patrol vessel will have a properly attached and fastened U.S. Coast Guard approved personal flotation device of appropriate size and fit, featuring a collar designed to float an unconscious person face up with the person's mouth out of the water. That means like this, rather than this type that Ellingson was put in. I did try getting in contact with the training instructor, Eldon Wolf, but I was told he retired September 1st. But on Highway Patrol's main page, Wolf discusses the importance of the Marine Operations training since Highway Patrol and Water Patrol merged in 2011.
This course offers a trooper that's interested in transferring to the Water Patrol Division a chance to see what it's like out on the water, operating a boat, making boat stops.
Piercy is an 18-year-old Highway Patrol veteran volunteering to help with Water Patrol after the merger. I did reach out to Brandon Ellingson's father and his father's lawyer today, but have not yet heard back. Last I spoke with the two of them a couple of weeks ago, they said they will file a wrongful death lawsuit.
Thank you, Heather. Ellingson's family is also wanting a review of Water Patrol's training.
We're learning.